Without further ado, let's give a warm applause.
Let me take you back to the mid-80s. In the mid-80s, there were three surprising discoveries on the structure of matter and its properties. The first, chronologically, was the discovery of particular crystals, and it was published in 1984. And the names are Meinl and Langer, Henri Barthes, which with us in this conference, and John Young. This happened in 1980. Years later, in 1985, fullerenes were discovered, and fullerenes really started the field of nanomaterials, and you see the names on that announcement. And the fourth announcement was a year later was high temperature superconductivity. Now, high temperature superconductivity was known from the turn of the century, the century now. But nobody expected high temperature superconductivity to exist. So when it was discovered, everybody was happy because now you could have superconductivity at liquid nitrogen temperature, and that means applications. There was no objection to the discovery. Fullerenes were just another way in which carbon atoms can erase themselves, and everybody was happy when this was discovered. When monomeric crystals were discovered, this was not the case, and it meant periods of resistance and objection. And I will tell you the story of the discovery of carbon-based crystals.
我们先来看一下，在1980年代中期。 关于物质的结构有三个重要的发现，第一个呢就是在1984年的时候，我发表了这一篇准周期晶体的论文，那也是跟我其他的同事共同发表的，谢谢他们一路上来协助。第二呢是1985年的时候，富勒烯，那富勒烯是另外一种很重要的物质啊。那1986年的时候呢，又有高温超导体发现，那高温超导体发现当然对于全世界来讲是非常重要的一个发明，我们现在也可以看到它应用在很多的材料上面。
Now, before we start our lecture, let me clarify several terms. And I will talk about order, I will talk about periodicity, and I will talk about rotational symmetry. Let's talk first about order. You see here an array of atoms. This is in two-dimensional space. This is a plane. And you see the atoms here. And clearly you can see that there is order there. If I would ask you to continue this array in this direction or in that direction, you would know how to do that. This is order.
我们要谈准晶体的，当然要先谈一下什么叫做有序性、周期性，还有旋转对称。先谈有序性，大家在这个图上可以看得出来呢，像这样的一个排列就是有秩序的。那这个排列它可以在这个连续它原本的这一种排列的方式，然后依照这个顺序可以照方向的展开。
Now, let's say a few words about very recent things. Look in this direction. Very good. The one that comes up here. This is a direction in the lattice. And you can clearly see that there is periodicity here. That means that if you measure the distance between this atom and this atom, it will be equal to the distance between here and here, and so on and so forth. This is periodicity.And periodicity occurs in each and every direction. Like in this direction, you see the periodicity here. Or in this direction, you can see the periodicity here. This is periodicity.
看一下周期性哦，那大家可以发现呢，依照我红线所标出来的地方，这边呢，大家看到它的间距都是相等的，然后也是一样朝着同一个方向呢，你可以找到好几个间距相等的排列，这就是我说的周期性。
Now, let's say something about rotational symmetry. See, here is the same lattice as before. Now I have every handle to it, so that you see what happens when I rotate it. When I rotate it 90 degrees, it looks exactly the same, except for the handle. 180 degrees, it looks the same, 270,And 360 look the same. So this lattice has a four-fold rotational symmetry. A four-fold rotational symmetry because you can rotate it four times and every time it looks the same. This is rotational symmetry.
再我们看一下旋转对称。那大家如果把图上那个红色的那一个地方长线的地方哈，把它当成是一个起点的话，刚才呢，现在教授把它转了90度，转了4次。那你会发现说，它不管转哪一次哦，看到的那个图形都还是一样的。所以这就是一个四重的旋转对称。
Let me give you a few examples of rotation symmetry. You see on the left, you see this card.This knob has a two-fold rotational symmetry. When you rotate it 180 degrees, then it will look the same. This has three-fold rotational symmetry. This flower five-fold. This pizza has six-fold rotational symmetry. And you can continue this array.
好，那我们再来多看一些关于旋转对称的例子。像图上面这个扑克牌呢，它就是一个二重的旋转对称，因为如果我们再把它转180度，看到的图形还是一样的。那我们也可以发现有五重的旋转对称，六重的，但是它这个数目还可以继续往下增加。
Now let's say a few words about crystallography. The field of crystallography really started in 1912.With the famous experiment by Murnau and his co-workers of X-ray diffraction. Now, before that, there was crystallography. The mathematics of crystallography was known, and many people dealt with crystallography, but they did not have a scientific tool to prove their ideas. In 1912, that scientific tool was discovered, and that was X-ray diffraction.And from 1912 until 1982, for 70 years, all the crystals that have been studied were ordered, and they were crystals, and they were also periodic. There was no exception. All crystals were periodic. And so, over time, a definition of the crystals has emerged, and that definition, which I will show you shortly,was accepted by all the community of crystallographers and all the community of scientific researchers as well.
那现在的结晶学呢，其实要追溯到1912年，是因为有著名的科学家冯劳二，他发现了这个 X 光照射的实验。其实，在1912年之前呢，我们对于这个结晶体它的有序性还有周期性，科学界早就已经有所了解，只是并没有一个科学的工具可以来证明。他1912年的时候，因为用了 X 光照射的实验，所以证明了这一点。 那从1912呢到1982年之间，将近70年的时间，所以研究的所有的晶体都是有序而且是有周期性的。那科学界呢，还有所有的科学研究的领域，大家都接受这样的定义，认为所有的晶体都应该具备这样的周期性。
So let's look at the definition of crystals until 1991. Here is one definition from the book called X-ray diffraction by Paletti. And the definition says the following. A crystal may be defined as a solid composed of atoms arranged in a pattern periodic in three dimensions. Another definition from another book from Arthur Masalski.Atoms in a crystal are arranged in a pattern that repeats itself in three dimensions throughout the interior of the crystal. Same definition requires order and periodicity.
在1991年以前的晶体的定义就像投影片上所显示的这样啊。我们看到了在1959年出版的这一本书 Quality 他所写的 X 光的绕射，它里面定义说呢，晶体就是固体里面的原子在三度空间当中是依照周期性排列的。那到1966年的时候 Barron 和 Masalski 也写了另外一本书，他们的定义是说晶体当中的原子是用固定的排列方式在晶体里面的三个方向反复出现。所以我们可以看到晶体的定义一直都是依照有序性和周期性来进行定义。
The photography in 1982, the early discovery, in an example of that comes from the book by Charles Kittel, Introduction to Solid-State Physics. I know that you cannot read it if you are around it for you, and it says the following. We can make a crystal from molecules which individually have a fine color rotation axis. But we should not expect the lattice to have a fine color rotation axis. That means a molecule.Or a motif can have many rotational symmetries, including cycles, but the lattice itself cannot have. Why so? Because of geometrical reasons, if you have periodic materials, you cannot expect cycles of rotational symmetry.
那我们再来看到1982年的时候还有出版了关于这本固态物理概论是 Charles Kittel 所写的，那这里面他也定义了结晶学哦，他这里的定义呢是说用五重旋转对称的分子可以组成晶体，但是它形成的晶格结构不可能有五重的旋转对称，所以也就是说如果是光是讲这个分子的旋转对称的话呢，它可以有很多种形式，那有很多重，可是如果是讲到晶格的话，他们认为是不可能有五
Now, let me show you a picture. It was taken by a high-resolution electron microscope. And this is a picture of carbon atoms in diamond. The diamond is a periodic material. Each one spot here is a carbon atom. And you can clearly see that there is order here, and there is periodicity.In each and every direction, in this direction there is periodicity, in this direction there is periodicity, any direction that you choose, there is periodicity. This is how crystals look, and this is how periodic crystals look. And in such periodic crystals, the rotation symmetries that are allowed are 1, 2, 3, 4, and 6, no 5-fold, and nothing beyond.
我们再来看一下这一张图，这个是在显微镜下面我们看到的钻石它的周期排列哦。那因为钻石呢，它是一个周期性有周期性的一个分子，在这里面我们可以看到说它碳原子的排列，那大家可以很明显的看得出来说，的确是有秩序而且是有周期性的，在任何一个方向而言都是如此。那这里可以看出来的旋转排列是只有1、2、3、4或者六重的旋转对称，所以并不可能有五重。或者高于六重的旋转对称，那大家对于晶体的看法都是如此。
Let me show